Today we'll be talking about the alphabet used in Bosnian, Croatian, Serbian, and to be more specific, we'll address the Latin script, which is one of the two scripts used in BCS, the second script being Cyrillic, which we will address in a different video. Before I begin going through the letters and the specific examples in BCS, I'd like to say a few things that you should probably, or you probably know by now, about the BCS alphabet. First thing is that it has 30 letters that correspond to 30 different sounds. So each letter represents a sound, and each sound can be written down as a single letter, meaning that this alphabet is phonetic. Now, in practice, that means that once you learn all 30 sounds and 30 letters, you can basically spell or read any word in BCS. Now, a few more things that I should mention is that, like I said, there are 30 letters in the alphabet, 25 of which are consonants and 5 vowels. The letter R can sometimes be a vowel, so keep that in mind. For all intents and purposes now, you should remember that R is a consonant, but sometimes acts as a vowel. So 25 consonants, 5 vowels. There are also 3 digraphs, which are basically 2 letters combined into one to represent a singular sound. So they're not separate letters. They represent one letter for all intents and purposes. And once we get to them, I'll point them out to you. So here we have the first 10 letters of the BCS alphabet. So let's start from the top. The first letter is the letter A, or as it is pronounced in BCS, A. A good example of the word of a word with that letter and that sound is the name, common name, Anna. Letter B is pronounced B, and you can hear it in the word Beograd, which is the name of the capital of Serbia. Third letter is C or C. This sound doesn't really correspond to any sound in English, but it can be heard in the word tzatziki, for example, or itz. And in BCS, you can hear it in the word cipala, which means shoe. Now, this C with a cairn is specific to BCS, and it's pronounced as ch. It has a pair, so this C with a little hat here, or a little line, is its pair, and one of them is harder, so ch is harder, and ch is a bit softer. You should pay attention to these two and try to differentiate the two sounds. Now, ch, it can be heard in the word chocolat, that means chocolate, so ch. Ch, which is a bit softer, can be heard in the word chewing, which means rug or carpet. Moving on to the next 5 letters, there's the letter D, which in BCS is pronounced as D, and it can be heard in the BCS word dan. Now, just like C has 2 other letters that are associated with it, so does D. One of them is J, which is our first digraph. It's a combination of the letter D and the letter J, but like I said, it's one sound, J. It's also a bit harsher sounding, just like ch, so pay attention to the difference between j and j, which we'll get to in a second. J can be heard in the word jep, which means pocket. J, like I said, corresponds to ch, and a good example is the word jak, meaning student. Now, when I ask you to differentiate between the two, I'm doing that for a reason, because if you mistake the two, you can very easily change the meaning of the word. So if we take the word jak and replace this j with a j, what we get is jak, which in BCS means a sack. So that's something to pay attention to. The next letter is the letter E in English, or as it is pronounced in BCS, E, and it can be heard in the word exit, meaning nail. Then there's F, which is very similar to the one in English. That is pronounced F. F. And you can hear it in the word fino, which means nice. So letters from 11 to 20 are G in English, or in BCS G, and word what that starts with G is garage, meaning garage, obviously. The letter H, or in BCS H, is not as commonly heard in English, so pay attention to it. H, or that can be heard in the word hvala, meaning thanks. Letter I is pronounced E, which can sometimes be confusing, but letter I is pronounced E, and you can hear it in the word igla, meaning needle. Letter J is pronounced as Y, and it can be heard in the word ya, meaning I, or myself. Letter K is pronounced as K, and you can hear it in the word kral. Letter L is pronounced L, so it can be heard in the word lopov. Now, L is our second compound letter. It's a combination of letters L and Y, but like I said before, it's one letter, it represents one sound, so treat it like that. And you can hear it in the word ljubav, meaning love. Letter M is pronounced M, as in the word mama, meaning mom. Letter N is pronounced as N, and you can hear it in the word ne. And we come to our third compound letter, which is N. So N and J, N and Y. It's one letter, one sound, N. And you can hear it in the word Nien. And the remaining 10 letters, after we've covered the first 20, are the following. Letter O in English is pronounced O in BCS, as in the word ovo, meaning this one. Letter P is pronounced P, as in Podgorica, which is the capital city of Montenegro. Letter R is pronounced as R. It's a bit different sounding than R in English, so pay attention to it and make sure you listen carefully when you hear a native speaker pronounce it. So R, or as it can be heard in the word Ruka. The letter S is pronounced S, as in Sarajevo, capital city of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Letter S with a Karen is pronounced sh, as in shah, or chess. Letter T is pronounced as t, as in tata, which means dad. Letter U is pronounced as u, as in ulica, meaning street. Letter V is pronounced V, as in veliki, meaning big or large. Letter Z is pronounced as Z, as in Zagreb, the capital of Croatia. And then, just like S has Sh, or Z has its own pair, Z, or Z with a Karen, which is pronounced as Ž, like I said, and can be heard in the word život, meaning life.